Indigenous cause AJ, Mississauga Donjiba, Makwadonam, which I'm saying is, my name is AJ. I am from Mississauga and I'm a bear clan. I've lived here all my life, born and raised. I love it here. I got the forest and I can go fishing, hunting. My son, I would take him out in the bush and I would teach him about the bush and the look on his face and how much he loved it. And then I started teaching him about the drum because I used to make drums when I was young. He was all over that. And then teaching him about hunting and fishing and all that, and he's still doing it today. We're pretty much like everybody embraced our culture on a reserve. I don't think there's anybody that doesn't. We all kind of like grew up that way. Learn about the morning sunrise ceremonies and pipe ceremonies. We build our own drums. That's what got me into painting. I loved painting because I loved animals. So I tried to draw it. So then I got into colors and then realized that I can make traditional paintings. So I went in that direction. Yeah, our culture is community-based, so we really get together, all of us, and we hold ceremonies like powwows, which creates all of our art that we put together. There's people that dance, there's people that drum, we have people like me that paint, and we love to share that with the world and us. That's the kind of people we are. I was in the point of where I didn't realize what I was going to do because I had a son and I was young. I was probably about 21 years old at the time. And I was scared. I was making paintings and I was selling them all across the North Shore, going to like different gas stations and wherever I can sell them. And I was making money for my family. All past that, that's when I started looking into trades so I can create a life for me and my family. Yeah, like I never knew I was ever gonna become a tradesperson. It was something that came up when I actually discovered that you can actually do this kind of stuff in a small community like the one we have, from the one I live in. When I was growing up, I used to collect cars and I loved cars. And then I found out, wow, you can paint cars. So from there, looked into it and found out that there's a place here in Blind River. So with me being an artist and all, this was a perfect job for me because it's just like my artwork. So I take something that's blank and I make it beautiful. And then in the work world, I get to take a broken car, make it beautiful, shiny, all brand new again. Makes it feel good inside, just like making a painting. Originally, my job title would have been a collision technician. And then further on, as we got through it, we noticed that I loved painting. So we had to get me in here. So I became the automotive painter. Daily responsibility would be first thing would be to go and find a paint color. And once I find a paint color, then I gotta go through a whole process of trying to figure out which one it is, because it could be 60 different alternates for one different color. Once you start into this trade, you could just start off by sweeping a floor, but then within a month, you could be sandblasting and you'll be grinding rust, and then you'll start a course. It's like, say if you do the apprenticeship like I did, you'll pretty much go to school for an 8-week program, and that'll be your level one. So then you go back to school the next year and you do another 8-week course and you're level two, and then so on, you'll do it again the next year. And even after that, it's all said and done, you can do your exam, but you're never gonna stop learning, because every single day in this place, you'll learn something new, and damage is always new and it's never the same. If you were looking into a job like this, you would be somebody that would like the challenge, somebody that would love to just try new things every day. Math is happening all the time in this job. You're constantly measuring, you're constantly trying to make something straight, changing paints and changing chemicals and all that kind of stuff and making it safe. Like if you're a handy person and you like fixing things and you like fooling around with new things all the time, this is like the greatest place for you. From the day I started here, I never actually thought I was gonna make it through a year. Kind of scared me a little bit. I didn't even know what a tool was. And I didn't know if I was ever gonna get through it. And I just took that little bit of time and learned everything that I can learn. And I got through it, and it makes me feel like 100%, more like 110 now. I'm very proud of myself and I'm well established now and I feel great. The coolest part about this job is that you take something that's broken and you make it better than it was.